Happy Lord's Day. Let us praise God that we have another Sunday that we can come together to worship Him. In Psalm 150, it says, "Praise the Lord, praise God in His sanctuary, praise Him in His mighty heavens, praise Him for His mighty deeds, praise Him according to His excellent greatness, praise Him with trumpet sound, praise Him with lute and harp, praise Him with tambourine and dance, praise Him with strings and pipe, praise Him with sounding cymbals, praise Him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord."
信息，每天清晨我领受新恩赐，我一切需要你多安排稳妥，何等大的信息主是给我，夏天即是春天，冬天接秋天，太阳也亮，诸星顺馈运行，我心相应，一周同真主之爱，上主万般心事，长存永在。何等大的信息，何等大的信息，每天清晨我领受新恩赐，我一切需要你多安排稳妥，何等大的信息主是给我，其实是追求恩，又是他平安，亲身向我显现威武万般，使我天天力量是光明前途，一手恩惠重重，还有千万，何等大的信息，何等大的信息，每天清晨我领受新恩赐，我一切需要你多安排稳妥，何等大的信息主是给我。
阮所信靠的天父上帝，创造天地万民的主宰，你是值得阮歌颂、敬拜、侍奉的唯一真神、万全能的上帝。虽然全世界以及阮拢处伫这个疫情的灾难中，但阮仍然要感恩，并且要称谢你，因为伫这个危难中，你已经保守了阮。少林教教会真侪兄弟姊妹，因为这个疫情的关系，生活、经济，拢受着真大个影响，甚至有只兄弟姊妹感染着一个病毒。但是主祈求圣灵个帮助，圣灵个引导，圣灵你个恩典，托因有法赢过。因为主你是听人个主，你是万全能个上帝。今仔日是敬拜你个日子，疫情困难无法阻挡兄弟姊妹要敬拜你的心。今天讲完的信息，求主圣，求圣灵的带领，托讲的甲听的同感接灵，托听的有通专心伫遐领受你所欲爱阮爱爱同阮讲的话，托讲的甲听的拢通得到真大大的益处。今日的奉献上赞，求主你的力。安尼祈祷，奉主耶稣基督的圣名，阿门。
彼得前书第二章第十一节到第十七节，亲爱的兄弟啊，恁是客旅，是寄居的，我劝恁着禁戒肉体的私欲，这私欲是甲灵魂征战的。恁伫外邦人中，应当品行端正，别怀疑谤恁是做歹的，因为看到恁的好行为，就伫监察的日子归荣耀乎上帝。恁为主的缘故，着顺服人的一切制度，甲宰相的君王， 甲君王所派、刑罚派、上司好的神才，因为上帝旨意，原是要恁行善，最好会通脱掉怀糊涂、无知的人的嘴。恁虽然是自由的，却毋通借着自由，加看恶毒，总要做上帝的仆人，的确要尊敬正人，亲爱教中的兄弟，敬畏上帝，尊敬君王。
Japanese occupation of the Philippines in 1942, a Christian family was imprisoned by the Japanese soldiers.
At the 第二次世界大战的时阵，日本占领菲律宾期间，有一个基督教的家庭受因在日本人掠去加禁3年久的时间。
Herb and Ruth Klingen and their young sons suffered for 3 years under the hand of the Imperial Japanese soldiers.
Herb and Ruth Klingen and their young sons suffered for 3 years under the hand of the Imperial Japanese soldiers.
The prisoners were tortured, killed, and starved. And one of the most hated and feared commandants is Konishi. Konishi, near the end of the war, found a way to severely torture the prisoners. Klingen narrated that Konishi increased the food ration but gave them palay, the unhusked rice, to eat.
Konishi,
eating rice with its razor sharp outer shell would cause intestinal bleeding that would kill them in hours. It was a death sentence for all the prisoners.
知影讲，咱咧咧食即跩米饭的时阵啊，但是伊也阁带着一个真正尖、真正赖的这个外壳，这个食落去的时阵啊，互跩肠啊遐来流血啊，甚至啊，互跩受犯啊，会伫几点钟内啊就会死亡啊。所以这个就是亲像伊互因拽了一个死刑啊。
But God spared the life of the Klingens and others. And in February of 1945, the Klingens and others were freed.
但是上帝饶恕了因一跩的Klingen 甲因跩其他人的性命。然后在1945年啊，因就伫遐得着逃亡。
After a few years, the Klingens learned that Konishi had been found working on Manila Golf Course as a groundskeeper.
过了几年啊，这个Klingen因这个家庭啊。才听到讲说，这个Konishi啊，来到伫马尼拉这个golf 的球场啊，来做球队的管理人啊。
He was put on a trial for his war crimes and hanged. Before his execution, he professed conversion to Christianity, saying he had been deeply affected by the testimony of the Christian family he had persecuted.
后来啊，因为伊也受了啊，就因为伊个战争的罪过啊，伊受了受审。并且受判死刑啊！但是伫伊也阁未受处刑之前啊，伊做了一个见证，伊讲说啊，伊真正听因为受到即跩伊所迫害的家庭啊的见证啊，伊就成做一位基督徒。
God used the Klingens' life and testimony to save a once murderer, torturer, and atheist like Konishi.
上帝。借着用这个经验，因这个家庭见证啊，来拯救了一位本来是真多杀人的犯人死刑刑罚者，了一个无神论者，亲像昆士。
It was indeed a great story of how powerful a good testimony to others can be, like the Christians in the Asia Minor whom Peter wrote the First Peter to.They were also experiencing persecutions and struggles, but Peter urged them to live a life that will glorify God and that will draw people to Christ.
咱听到一个实际的真正伟大的一个好的见证，互别人咱知影讲说有好的见证啊，对别人来讲就有一个真大的影响力啊。所以，亲像伫小亚细亚的即跩基督徒啊，彼得也是同样啊，社会间讲的时阵啊，伊知影讲说，因是咧经历啊真侪迫害，甲竞争啊，但是彼得继续啊，敦促因啊，就活出一个。
The title of our message today is Being a Living Testimony for Jesus. And our passage is found in 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 11 to 17.
今天早起，咱的对目就是讲说，咱要怎样为耶稣做啊，活着做一个活的见证啊。然后，咱的经文记载伫彼得前书第二章。
Christians are called to live a life that will glorify God and point people to Christ. But how can we live a life that will glorify God and point people to Christ? There are three important commands in our passage that we should follow. First, we should develop a life of holiness. Beloved, I urge you as sojourners and exiles to abstain from the passions of the flesh, which wage war against your soul.
第十二节，你讲亲爱的兄弟啊，恁是客旅，是寄徛的，我肯定着金戒玉体的需要，这个需要是甲心啊甲灵魂竞争。Do
you know someone who was born and raised here in the Philippines and later on migrated to another country? Once that person migrates, he slowly adapts to the new environment, language, way of life, and worldview of that country. But as you can notice, even though a migrant gets a new citizenship and is living in his new home, you will still determine where that person came from the way he talks, the way he thinks, the way he acts, and the way he desires food. He would like to eat food that came from his original country.
So, 当然是注意到啊，但是虽然这个人啊，已经移民了啊，伊也退了这个新的公民的身份啊，因为徛了徛伫这个新的所在啊，但是咱甲伊讲话，甲伊三句的时候，咱也过会看会发当认出讲，这个人是对什么所在来啊？因为对伊的讲话啊，对伊的行动啊，伊的生活方式啊，伊所爱食的物件，咱就知讲伊是对什么所在来。
Christian life can be likened to that of the migrant who was given a new citizenship. We were born sinners and used to live in the sinful world. Our thoughts, our feelings, our desires, and our actions are shaped by this fallen world. Why Peter urged the believers to abstain from the passions of the flesh.
就是因为安尼啊，所以彼得啊，叫诸位基督徒啊、信徒啊，就啊，更改家己肉体的使用。If
you will notice, Peter addressed them as beloved, reminding them that they are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, and a people for his own possession. They are no longer slaves of sin. They are no longer followers of Satan. They are now God's beloved children. He said, "Beloved, I urge you as sojourners and exiles to abstain from the passions of the flesh." The word abstain implies the ability to run from, to flee, to restrain from doing. You know, someone who is a slave to sin cannot abstain from sinning. But a true Christian can abstain from sinning because it is God Himself who liberated us from the bondage of sin through the blood of Christ. Apostle Paul mentioned the passions of our flesh, and he said in Galatians 5:19-21, "Now the works of the flesh are evident: sexual immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, rivalries, dissensions, divisions, envy, drunkenness, orgies, and things like
these." 邪动、拜偶像、邪术、羞愤、精进、欺负、懦弱、激动、纷争、纷争、异端、妄动、追究、封印、定律、行。
Peter is saying that now that you are a Christian, you should get away from those sinful desires. You are now children of God and citizens of heaven.
彼得就是在说，咱现在已经是上帝的子民。
Peter said, "Abstain from the passions of the flesh which wage war against your soul." The phrase "wage war" is a term that means to carry out a long-term military campaign. It's a long-term war. It tells us that the war between the flesh and the spirit will always be there. We will always experience the struggle as long that we are living in this world. That is why we must never put our guards down. You know, some people who was infected by COVID-19, it is because they put their guard down. They became complacent.
So we don't want to help them. We want to be really careful. You know, there are a lot of people in this world. 疫情的下面，搁再受感染，原因就是因为因开始自愿，因开始袂记得安生。In
the same way, in our Christian life, we should never be complacent, but intentionally pursue a life of holiness.
所以，咱做一个基督徒的，在咱的生活顶面，咱也是袂用放松，咱着真正刻意来追求一个圣洁的生活。
The authenticity of our public testimony is best seen in our private disposition. Brothers and sisters, pursue holiness in the Lord. Pursue holiness from our private life. It must be from the inside to outside.
咱伫这个公开所讲的话语，真实，是对伫咱的私生活的当中啊，第有法当真清楚的看到。所以兄弟姊妹啊，咱特刻着追求伫上帝内面的圣洁啊，然后离开肉体的罪恶甲罪恶啊。So
how can we be a living testimony for Jesus? First, we should develop a holy life. Second, we should demonstrate an honorable lifestyle.
所以咱要怎啊？我当话为主活出一个活的见证里面头一点，咱就是培养一个圣洁的生命。第二，咱就表现出咱有一个高尚的生活方式。
And it says, keep your conduct among the Gentiles honorable, so that when they speak against you as evildoers, they may see your good deeds and glorify God on the day of visitation.
恁伫外邦人中应当着凭证端正，叫伊怀回报恁是作恶的，因为看见恁的好行为，便伫监察的日子归荣耀给上帝。When
Apostle Peter wrote this, he was well aware of the slander that the unbelievers are committing against the Christians. First, from the emperor himself, he accused the Christians of burning the city of Rome, which he himself did. Also, the Christians are accused by the society for being evildoers, for rebelling against the Roman government because they don't bow down to the emperor nor to the Roman gods. They were also accused of cannibalism and incest. But Peter is telling the Christians to live the opposite way they are accused of. They must live an honorable life despite the slander and persecutions they are receiving.
The
word honorable means beautiful, attractively good, good that inspires.
其实，光荣的意思就是讲到真正美丽、真正漂亮，并且会激发灵感的好处。Christians
are ought to live in a way that people will be attracted to our gospel message. Our lives must echo the gospel we proclaim. When people look at you, when they observe your life, who do they see? What do they feel?
当一个无信的人伫咧看、咧观察你的时阵，因看到的是什么呢？因所感觉到的是什么呢？
A story was shared to me about a man who used to be a song leader in their church.
有一人甲我分享一个故事啊，伊讲到一个人啊，逐摆伫因的教会啊，就是咧做领奖。One
day, while he was driving towards the mall's parking lot, an old man and his grandson suddenly crossed the pedestrian lane.
第二日啊，当伊到这个商场的时阵，伊在要换去拍车，忽然间伫个头前啊，一个老人啊，甲伊的孙啊。
The driver did not see the old man crossing, but the good thing was that he was able to step on the brake. The old man and his grandson were safe, but the driver became so furious towards them that he got down from his car, shouted and cursed at the old man. One Sunday, someone invited the old man to the church. And as he was singing the worship song, to his surprise, the song leader that day was no other than the driver who shouted and cursed at him. Thankfully, this song leader repented and is now faithfully serving God in his local church. But this story should remind us of the importance of living an honorable life wherever we are and whoever we are
with.
Friends, when you are in the house, in your workplace, in your school, when you are driving an EDSA, when you are in the grocery, when you are talking to a customer or a waiter, do we reflect Jesus? Are they attracted to Jesus or they mock Jesus because of how we live our lives?
When
we live an honorable life among the unbelievers, we will have the credibility and effectiveness in sharing the gospel to them. May our lives echo the gospel we proclaim. Third, to become a living testimony for Jesus, we should demonstrate submission to civil authority. And it says in verses 13 to 14, be subject for the Lord's sake to every human institution, whether it be for the emperor as supreme or to governors sent by him, to punish those who do evil and to praise those who do good. In verse 11, Peter emphasized that as Christians, we are just foreigners in this world and our citizenship is in heaven. Therefore, our ultimate submission belongs to our God.
So
Yet Peter clarified in this section that not because we are citizens of heaven, we can be rebellious or disobedient to our earthly authorities. If we want to be a living testimony for Jesus, Peter is saying that we should submit to our earthly authorities whom our God himself placed to govern over civil matters. Apostle Paul also mentioned in Romans 13, 1-2, let every person be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and those that exist have been instituted by God. Therefore, whoever resists the authorities resists what God has appointed, and those who resist will incur judgment. Here we can see that God commands us and expects us to submit to civil authorities because, number one, it is God who instituted them. To submit to them is to acknowledge that God is sovereign over the affairs of the world, and that the kings and presidents, whether they acknowledge God or not, they serve the purposes of God. Number two, it is for the Lord's sake. And it says, be subject for the Lord's sake to every human institution. We submit to glorify God. We submit because we acknowledge that they are in the position because of God's divine appointment. I know some of us are having a hard time submitting to our authorities because of what's happening in our government and how and the character of our government leaders. But I pray that this will be your motivation, that you're going to submit for the Lord's sake. You know, Jesus, even though he was oppressed by the Jewish and Roman leaders, he did not oppose their leadership. Jesus certainly rebuked the sins of the Jewish leaders, but he did not abolish the right to rule. Jesus did not lead a coup d'etat against the Roman Empire.
But 统管的管理跟毁掉。耶稣基督也无起来政变对这个罗马的政府来政变。
In fact, he submitted himself even to the unjust judgment and death sentence of the Roman Empire.
伊事实上，伊并且屈服伫这个罗马政府无公正审判，甲判伊死刑的这样代志。
Why?Because Jesus was more concerned with the advancement of his kingdom than with the matters of the earthly kingdom.
为什么啊？所以安尼做呢？因为伊真正清楚，伊真正知影，伊较关心的，就是伊国度的发展，赢过对手国度的代志。
But you may be asking, to what extent, Pastor, will I submit to the government authorities?
有时阵，咱问这个问题，讲说，我要顺服。
There is an exemption to this. If the government leaders commands us to do something that is contrary to the command of our God, then that is the time we don't submit to them.
咱就会记得，这个顺服有一个例外，就是当这些政府人员、政府的领袖命令咱做一件代志，是违背。上帝所给咱的命令的时阵，安尼咱就袂用顺服伊。
Because again, our ultimate submission belongs to our true King, the Lord Jesus.
因为你得记得讲说，咱最终的顺服是属于咱的真正的君王耶稣基督。
Third, we should submit to civil authorities because it silences the ignorance of foolish people.
第三点，咱就顺服这个对象的领袖，原因是啥物呢？因为安尼做会塌掉许块无功无德的人的嘴。
And it says, for this is the will of God, that by doing good, you should put to silence the ignorance of foolish people.
所以十五节讲了，因为上帝旨意，原是恁要恁行好，通塌掉迄个糊涂无德的人的嘴。
We are to submit because it is God's will for us to do the right thing, which is to submit so that the mouths of those who oppose the gospel, those who criticize the gospel, may be stopped.
咱就顺服，因为这个是上帝的旨意，爱咱做正确的代志。就是什么是正确的代志呢？咱顺服，托这些咧反对福音的人。并且咧批评福音的人，和因的嘴的停止。
Peter is saying that we should not allow the unbelievers to use our defiance towards authority as their basis to mock the gospel.
彼得在这里跟人讲的，就是讲说，咱唔忙啊，温存别人，因为咱藐视即跩有官兵啊，和因有机会通来讥笑咱所信的这个福音。
We should be obedient to the civil authority and law.
咱就即跩啊，对即跩的对象啊，一定受来啊顺服。
For example, you know, I know some people, although they are not yet a senior citizen or they are not a PWD, they would still present a senior citizen or PWD ID to the counter.Just to get a discount.
亲像比如安尼讲，咱知影讲咱中间有真侪人，因也阁唔是属地老年人，因也唔是即跩展会的人，但是因会去创一张假安尼款的证明，所以去到一家点头的时阵，因就会将跩牌推出来，为着要干哪只，为着要贴着一个折扣。
Let us not do that, because such things are defiance and dishonesty. Do not allow such acts to let unbelievers mock the gospel.
咱唔忙安尼做，因为当咱安尼做的时候，咱就是藐视即跩律法，并且这个是无诚实的。咱这款所做的这款行动行为，会互爱无信的人来讥笑讲咱所相信的福音。
Instead, we should act and live.As servants of God.
咱乃是着活出做一个上帝中心的仆人的形象。
Peter said, "Live as people who are free, not using your freedom as a cover-up for evil, but living as servants of God."
第十六节一个彼得个人讲，恁虽然是自由的，却唔忙加个自由来加看恶毒，总要做上帝的仆人。
John MacArthur said, "Freedom in Christ and citizenship in the kingdom of God in no way permit believers to abuse or disregard the standards of conduct God has established for them on earth."
John MacArthur 伊正正安尼讲啊，伊在基督内的自由甲上帝国度啊，做上帝国度的主民啊。并无予咱允准咱啊，在信徒滥用、滥三用，还是无主、无看上帝的对象，为伊所建立的这个行为的标准。
Friends, let us act as a true citizen of the kingdom of God. May our lives cause the unbelievers to seek the God we worship and respond to the gospel we proclaim.
咱兄弟姊妹，咱就活出一个啊真正的这个。为基督徒生活，为基督徒做一个活的见证的生活。
As we hear the word of God today, how can we apply this to our daily life?
咱所听见的，咱今仔日要怎样应用伫咱日常的生活顶面呢？
Our passage provided for us the practical steps on how we can be a living testimony for God. Peter summed up his teachings with these four practical applications.
今仔日的经文，啊，人看到讲，咱的主啊，叫我当为着主活出一个我爱见证。伊点也照着伊的书信所讲的，做了一个提出四个真正实际应用的方法来做今仔日的总结。
And he said, honor everyone, love the brotherhood.Fear God and honor the emperor.
伊只讲第十七节，务必尊敬敬人，亲爱教众的兄弟，敬畏上帝，尊敬君王。
First, honor everyone.
头一项就是咱要尊敬每一个人。
What does it mean to honor everyone?
尊敬每一个人的意思是啥物呢
？During the time of Peter, not everyone is treated fairly, especially if you're not a Roman citizen.He's saying that we should not treat people based on their status, on their looks, race, color, or economic background, but everyone should be treated with respect.
咱唔忙用伊个地位、伊个相貌、伊个种族，还是伊个经济背景来来分做工具。咱乃是着对待每一个人拢尊重每一个人。
Sometimes it is tempting to look down on other people because they are different from us. But Peter is saying that we should look at them as people made in the image of God.
有时阵，咱真正容易。爱看轻一寡的人，因为跩人甲咱无相同。但是彼得伫咧提醒咱讲说，咱伫看人的时阵，咱着看每一个人，亲像伊是用上帝形象来创造的。
Second, love the brotherhood.
第二就是讲说，咱着听咱的兄弟。
We have to let the world see and know how we love our brothers and sisters in Christ genuinely.
咱着需要让这个世界。来看的公式，咱怎啊真正真心诶来听咱诶跩兄弟姊妹。
They must see that the body of Christ is living in harmony. For how can we preach the gospel of reconciliation to others if there is disunity, strife, and unforgiveness in the relationship inside the church?
咱就这个世界看的公式，这个耶稣基督的身躯就是咱。在教会每一个兄弟姊妹，怎啊彼此相听？咱若无安尼创，咱要怎啊有法当可以看到方式？伫这个教会甲耶稣基督的身躯顶面呢，有真正的这个上帝听伫当中。
Third is to fear God。
第三点，咱得敬畏上帝。
Friends, to fear God means to respect Him, to revere Him, to worship Him。
敬畏上帝意思是啥物呢？咱得尊重伊。咱就听伊，咱就敬拜。
If we have this reverence for God, we will not pursue sin. We will not play with sin. We will we will run away from sin.
咱若对上帝有一款尊敬的心、宽容的心的时阵， 咱就袂爱去追究这个罪，咱会避这个罪。
If we fear God, we will not do something that will offend God.
咱若敬畏上帝， 咱会袂去做一项物件来得罪伊。
Fourth is to honor the emperor or the president.
第四点是讲，咱要尊敬即跩皇帝，也是总统。
The equivalent of the emperor in world, the president.
现在这个世代这个皇帝就是等于咱现在国家的这个总统。
No matter who is seated in Malacañang, we should learn to respect them, knowing that God who placed.
无论什么人坐伫这个总统府，啊，徛伫总统府的内面，咱就学习来顺服伊，因为咱知影伊今仔日的地位是上帝所赋予的。One
of the best ways to honor the president is to pray for him and also the other leaders of the land.
咱第有法当来帮助甲顺服这个总统的方法，就是为着伊祈祷。 不是单单伊，也为着这个国家内面其他的领袖来祈祷。
We should pray that God will open His heart to see and acknowledge our true King, the Lord Jesus, and may He lead well so that we may live in peace.
咱为祈祷，就是爱讲说，互上帝来开伊的心，并且互伊看到，甲圣灵讲说，伊真正的王，真正的君王，乃是耶稣基督。
As we close, let me ask this question, brothers and sisters. Is your life drawing people to the Lord or away from the Lord?
咱们结束的时阵，我们问恁这个问题，兄弟姊妹，你的生命有咧吸引人来归等耶稣基督，还是如何因离开耶稣基督？
We only have a short time left in this world. Let's say 20, 30, 40 years.
咱活在这个世界。 咱的生命实在真短，咱只不过有二十年、三十年、四十年的时间。But
how is your life making a difference to the lives of others? Is your life making Jesus attractive to the unbelievers?
是咱的生命有底下咧帮助别人无？咱的生命有法当让无信的人会看到基督在咱的心中，还是无？It
is my prayer that by God's grace, we will live a life that will glorify God and will draw people to Christ.
我祈祷是希望讲说，咱每一个人所活出的生命，是有法当荣耀上帝的生命，并且有法当吸引人来归向耶稣基督的生命。Have
a blessed Sunday, grace and peace to all of you.
希望咱每一个人都得到一个蒙福的主日，愿主祝福咱每一位。
Let us receive the benediction. Now, may our Lord Jesus Christ Himself, and God our Father, who loved us and gave us eternal comfort and good hope through grace, comfort your hearts and establish them in every good work and word. Amen and amen. Thank you.
Resting in